Aside from destroyers and aircraft carriers, many countries are upgrading and developing new frigates to strengthen their naval force. These next-generation frigates have undergone many changes and are designed mainly to offer a minimal radar cross-section, thus are stealthy compared to the old ones. They are also equipped with the latest and advanced weapons. Today, let's check out the 10 upcoming frigates of the world. So firstly, we have the FFX-3. This is a new class of lightweight anti-air warfare AAW frigate to be commissioned by 2024 to 2025 for the Republic of Korean Navy. This class is expected to consist of 6 vessels to be built by Hyundai Heavy Industries, while Rolls-Royce will deliver the MT-30 gas turbines, which will serve as the major propulsion system for the ships. The Batch 3 will be 129 meters in length, 15 meters in width, displays 3,500 tons, and have a maximum speed of 30 knots. Its major armaments include a Mark 45 5-inch main gun, ship-to-ship missile, and a new close-in weapon system. Up next is the frigates of the intermediate size. This is a French military program to design and create a planned class of frigates to be used by the French Navy. At the moment, the program consists of 5 ships, with commissioning planned from 2023 onwards. The FTI medium-sized frigate will feature a modular design with increased self-defense and long-range capabilities. It will incorporate digital technologies for data processing and detection of evolving threats, and will be armed with a variety of anti-aircraft and anti-submarine armament to attack aircraft and submarines and their crew. Up next is the Hunter-class frigate. This is a future class of frigates for the Royal Australian Navy to replace the Anzac class. Construction is expected to begin in 2020, with the first of 9 vessels to enter service in the late 2020s, maybe 2027. The program is expected to cost $35 billion, and the class will have 8,800-ton full-load displacement, will be approximately 149.9 meters in length. The vessel will be capable of sailing in excess of 27 knots and will have a full complement of 180 crew. It will be able to carry one MH-60R ASW helicopter and have the ability to host other Australian aircraft such as the MRH-90 helicopter. Up next is the MKS-180, also known as F-126 frigate. This is a new multi-purpose combat ship being developed for the German Navy. It is planned to be commissioned by 2027, and the ships are to be the largest surface warships to join the Navy since World War II. MKS-180 frigate will have an overall length of 160 meters, a displacement of 10,000 tons. It will be capable of performing maritime surveillance and embargo control, including boarding, military evacuations during a crisis, escorting merchant ships, and leading task forces at sea, and support self-defense and combat missions. Next, we have the Mogami-class frigate, also known as the 30FFM, 30FF, 30DX, and 30DEX. This is a Japanese multi-mission stealth frigate for the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force. Construction of the Mogami began in 2018, and a total of 22 units is planned by 2032. Weapons include a Mark 45 gun, 2 remote weapon stations above the bridge, 16 Mark 41 VLS at the bow, 8 anti-ship missiles, 1 SRAM, an SH-60L helicopter, torpedoes and decoy launchers. It will have a length of 133 meters and a displacement of 5,500 tons when fully loaded. Up next, we have the Istanbul-class frigates. This is a planned group of 4 frigates for the Turkish naval forces. Developed under the Milgram National Warship Program, this class is an enlarged version of the Ada class, which feature a slightly larger hull for improved endurance and Mark 41 vertical launch system for multi-role capability. The Istanbul class will have twice the number of anti-ship missiles and will be equipped with the Mark 41 VLS, capable of firing at Maka, HISAR, RIM-66 Standard, RIM-162 EWSM, and VLASROC missiles, along with other systems for improved multi-role combat capabilities. Up next is the Type 31 frigate, which is a planned class of frigate for the United Kingdom's Royal Navy, intended to enter service in 2027. The Type 31 ship will have a length of approximately 140 meters, displacement of more than 5,700 tons, and the capacity to accommodate 105 crew members. The new warship features a unique modular design that supports different configurations to meet the demands of the Royal Navy as well as allied navies across the world. The Sea Scepter Advanced Naval Air Defense System, which will be integrated into the frigate for protection against existing and emerging threats. Next, we have the Nilgiri-class frigate, which are a series of stealth-guided missile frigates being developed for the Indian Navy. This frigate's design incorporates a significant degree of stealth and low radar observability. A total of 7 ships will be built, and the construction of the first ship started in 2017. The ship will have a length of 49 meters and a displacement of 6,670 tons. The weapons platform in the Project 17A ships will be compact, and they will be armed with the Barak 8 and Brahmos. The construction times will be reduced and productivity will be improved by using modular integrated construction. Next is the Type 26 frigate or City-class frigate. This is a class of frigates being built for the United Kingdom's Royal Navy, with variants also being built for the Australian and Canadian navies. It is expected to enter service from 2028. The program, also known as the Global Combat Ship, was launched by the UK Ministry of Defence to partially replace the Navy's 13 Type 23 frigates and for export. Its primary role is to conduct advanced anti-submarine warfare missions while supporting air defence and general purpose operations. The type is the first naval platform shared between Australia, Canada, and the United Kingdom since the Tribal-class destroyer. And last but not the least, we have the Constellation class. This is a class of multi-mission guided missile frigates under development for the United States Navy as a follow-on to the modular littoral combat ship. In January 2019, the US Navy announced that this new frigate will have a minimum of 32 Mark 41 vertical launch system cells aboard the ship for primarily anti-air warfare, for self-defense or escort missions. The US Navy would like for the ship to be able to destroy surface ships over the horizon, detect enemy submarines, defend convoy ships, employ active and passive electronic warfare systems, and defend against swarming small boat attacks. Well, that, guys, was the 10 upcoming frigates of the world. We hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you did, don't forget to hit that notification and subscribe button for more videos from the Buzz. Thank you guys for viewing in. Bye-bye.